we had a negative year-over-year effect on volumes, mainly driven by lower private label sales in North America. Our branded and premium products are continuing to develop really well, and we're really happy about the development. We have been able to realize pricing to offset the headwinds, and we're continuing to drive positive mix, meaning that we're selling more of our more innovative, more highly featured products, contributing to profitability. So we're quite pleased with the development.
And so you're one of the companies that's been very much caught in the crosswinds of the trade war and extra tariffs being applied in your space on steel and aluminium. What I thought was really interesting is a comment in your earnings release today, and similar to the last quarter, you said that you've managed to introduce price hikes and that those price hikes have fully offset tariffs. Is that still expected to be the case in the future? Can you really pass through those tariff hikes one for one to the consumer?
We've had to, and we have, and of course it's not something that we like, because of course the higher prices do have an impact on demand ultimately, and we have seen somewhat softer demand mainly in North America as a result of these price hikes, and so that's an unfavorable development. But yes, we have no choice but to pass on the higher cost that we are getting.
Well, there is another choice, and that is by going for efficiency gains. And you said a few months ago that you're looking to modernize some of your plants in America, North America, South America. Can you give us a little bit more color on the developments there?
Yes, absolutely. And that's unrelated to the tariff. Of course, we are in a very competitive industry, and we need to continuously work to improve our efficiency. And we have a very, very strong and long track record of doing that. What we're doing now is a combination of product feature innovation, better product experiences, through a modularization of our product architectures and automation of our manufacturing. So that's our largest investment program ever. We've talked about an additional 8 billion SEK over the coming years, leading to a 3 billion Swedish krona annual cost efficiency improvement. So. And we're right in the middle of those things. We're ramping up our large refrigeration facility in Anderson, South Carolina, U.S. right now, with really exciting products and super modern facility. So we're excited about that, and we do expect that to continue to contribute to earnings improvement going forward.
Hi, I'm Giovanna Bersecci, and thank you for watching. You can check out more of our videos by clicking on the boxes on the screen. And don't forget to subscribe to our channel for more from CNBC International. Thank you for watching.